Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, we will cover the difference between the 32-bit and 64-bit versions of Windows 7. We'll go over how to check our Windows Vista or Windows 7 computer to see which version is installed. This will also be beneficial to individuals installing Windows to determine whether to install the 32-bit or the 64-bit version. The computer industry is moving from a 32-bit to a 64-bit computer architecture. 32-bit systems are limited to using a maximum of 4 gigabytes of memory, RAM, which in reality turns out to be closer to 3.5 gigabytes. 64-bit systems, at least on paper, can access up to 16 exabytes of memory, or more than 4 billion times more than 32-bit. Windows 7 can handle a maximum of 192 gigabytes of memory. Additional benefits of 64-bit systems over 32-bit systems are enhanced security with hardware-backed data execution prevention, mandatory driver signing, and kernel patch protection. I recommend that you always install the 64-bit version of Windows, unless the following scenarios apply to you. If you are using a computer that is very old, although your system may allow you to install Windows, older systems are likely to have certain hardware, like the sound card or graphics card, that will not have a working driver. Almost everything made after 2006 should have a 64-bit compatible driver. If your computer doesn't have at least 4 gigabytes of memory, then you won't get any real benefit. Installing 64-bit might still be the right choice if you plan on adding more memory later. All you have to do is put it in, and the system will recognize it. If you installed 32-bit, then you would have to reinstall the 64-bit version of Windows before you could make use of the upgraded memory. If you have very old software that is not compatible, and that software is essential to you, then you wouldn't want to install the 64-bit version of Windows. Microsoft has an online upgrade advisor that will tell you if your system meets the requirements to upgrade. It will check both hardware and software. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. Go to your favorite search engine, in my case, google.com. In the search field, type in Windows Upgrade Advisor. The top link should be http://windows.microsoft.com/upgradeadvisor. If it's not, enter that address here. On the Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor page, scroll down and click on the Download Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor button. Find the Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor setup.exe file and click on the Download button. On the Download information bar, click the Run button. If you have user account control enabled, click the Yes button to allow it to make changes. The Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor window will open. Click to select the radio button next to I accept the license terms, and click the Install button. The installation should take just a minute. Once complete, you will see the installation complete screen. Click the Close button. Now, you can either double-click the icon on the desktop, or click on the Start button, All Programs, Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor. If you have user account control enabled, click the Yes button to allow changes. The Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor window will open. Make sure that all of your peripheral devices are turned on, such as printers and scanners, so that they are checked for compatibility. Click the Start Check button. Once it completes, it will tell you if your system meets the requirements, and if there is any trouble hardware or software that needs attention before upgrading. I am already running Windows 7, so it won't find any problems that I can show you. I'm going to cancel the check and close the program. Now I will show you how to check to see what version of Windows is installed on your system. Click the Start button, then right-click on My Computer, and select Properties. the System Properties window will open. Under the System section, next to System Type, it shows the version of Windows installed. If it's the 64-bit version, as is the case here, it will show 64-bit operating system. If it is 32-bit, then it will show 32-bit operating system. Here in the System Properties page, you can also find the version of Windows installed. Here you can see that I have Windows 7 Home Edition installed. If installed, a service pack will show here. In this case, we have Service Pack 1 installed. It shows the processor, or CPU, that you have in your system. In this case, it's an AMD Phenom 2 X3720 processor running at 3.11 GHz. You also have the amount of physical RAM installed, which in this case is 4 GB. You should now have a general understanding of the differences and benefits of 32-bit and 64-bit systems. You should be able to determine what version is right for you if you are planning to install Windows, and you should be able to check what version of Windows you are running, and you should be able to check what version of Windows you are currently running.